Hello everyone. So in today's lecture, we are going to discuss about the setback distance on the horizontal curve. So your setback distance is basically the clearance distance required from the center line of the horizontal curve to an obstruction on the inner side of the road to provide adequate side distance. So what does this mean is that suppose we have a horizontal curve, okay, and at the inner side of that curve there is an obstruction. Now this obstruction can be in the form of any building, in the form of trees, in the form of natural topography or anything, right? Now what this obstruction do is it hinders the line of sight of the vehicle that is coming from one side of the horizontal curve. So if a vehicle that is coming from this direction, because of this obstruction it won't be able to see the happening on the other side of the horizontal curve. So by providing a certain clearance from the center line of the horizontal curve to the object, we try to improve the side distance of the vehicle as soon as it crosses the obstruction. Okay, so what happens is that suppose this is the center line of the horizontal curve. Okay, so a certain clearance is provided from the center line to the obstruction as soon as the vehicle passes this obstruction. So as soon as the vehicle passes this obstruction, it will be able to see what is happening on the other side of the horizontal curve. So by providing this clearance, which is represented by M, the side distance is improved for the vehicle. Now this clearance is provided from the center line of the horizontal curve to the obstruction, and this is represented by M, and this clearance is called as setback distance. Okay, so this is the setback distance that is provided from the center line of the horizontal curve to the obstruction, from the inner obstruction that is present at the inner side of the horizontal curve. Okay, so as to improve the side distance of the vehicle that is traveling at that side of the curve. Alright, so it is the clearance distance required from the center line of the horizontal curve to the obstruction on the inner side of the road to provide adequate side distance. Now this setback distance depends upon the side distance, it depends upon the radius of the curve, and it depends upon the length of the curve. And here we have a different scenario that sometime length of the curve can be greater than the side distance, and in other times your length of the curve can be less than the side distance. So these are the factors which governs the setback distance. So as we were discussing, we have two cases. That the first case is when length of the curve is greater than the side distance, and in this again we have two sub cases. The first is for single lane road and the other is for double lane road. Likewise, the second case is when the length of the curve is less than the side distance. Here again we have two cases, for the single lane road and the double lane road. So now let's take up each of the cases and derive the mathematical expression for the setback distance. Taking the case 1, that is the length of the curve is greater than the side distance, and for the single lane road. So let us assume that this is the center line of the horizontal curve. So we have a horizontal curve something like this, and this is the center line of the horizontal curve, okay, and then we have an obstruction which hinders the line of sight of the vehicle. And as soon as the vehicle crosses this obstruction, the vehicle from this side can see the event that are taking place at the other side of the horizontal curve. So this is the line of sight of the vehicle as soon as it crosses the obstruction. So basically this is the sight distance for this curve. This is the sight distance S for this curve. So this is the length of the curve. The total length of the curve is this, while sight distance is this. Alright, so that's why we have length of the curve is greater than the sight distance. The radius of the curve is R, and we have to calculate the setback distance M, which is the distance from the center line of the horizontal curve to the obstruction that is present at the inner side of the curve. Alright. Now let us assume that if we join the center of the curve with the two edges of the side distance, it makes an angle alpha, and if we draw a line, the alpha is bisected into alpha by 2 and alpha by 2. Alright, so this is the scenario. So now let us find out the setback distance M. So first of all, let us name the point A, B, and this point as C. Okay, this is the radius of the curve, and this is, since this is the curve, so all these are the radius of the curve, right? So this is also the radius of the curve, right? This is also radius of the curve. So we can say that your setback distance M is equal to R minus BO, right? So it can be R minus BO. Now let us find BO. For this, let us take triangle ABO, and from there, if we say cos alpha by 2 is equal to BO by AO, and AO is nothing but the radius of the curve, so BO divided by R. So we can say that BO is R cos alpha by 2, right? So your M becomes R minus R cos alpha by 2. All right, and we know that L is equals to R theta, that is length of the curve is equal to radius of the curve and the angle that it makes. So here L is equals to the side distance. So you see, whenever the length of the curve is greater than the side distance, we always take length as a side distance, because this is what we are interested in. We want to have a setback distance that ensures that the vehicle has appropriate side distance for the respective curve. Alright, so here we will take S is equals to radius is R into angle alpha. Now since here angle is alpha by 2, if you can say S by 2 is equals to R into alpha by 2. So your alpha by 2, that is angle alpha by 2, becomes S divided by 2R. This is in radians. Converting it into degree, we will have S divided by 2R into 180 divided by pi degree. Okay, so this is the expression for alpha by 2. So your alpha by 2 is S by 2R, 180 by pi degree, and your setback distance M is equal to R minus R cos alpha by 2 for length greater than the side distance, and we have single lane road. Now moving on to the next case, that is length of the curve is greater than the side distance for the double lane road. Now here again we have the center line of the horizontal curve. Now here what is happening is that we have two lane road. Earlier we had single lane road. So first of all we have the horizontal curve whose center line is this, right? And in that curve this is the lane 1, this is the lane 2, and then we will also consider the center line of this second lane, that is lane that is at the inner side of the curve, right? Lane that is at the inner side of the curve, we will take the center line of that too. All right, so this is the center line of the lane that is present at the inner side of the curve. This lane is situated at a distance d. Now we have obstruction. Now this should be kept in mind that in this case we are taking the position or the line of sight position from the inner lane, right? We are not taking the center line of the horizontal curve as our for the line of sight, right? Earlier, in the earlier case we were taking the line of sight with respect to the center line. Now we are taking the line of sight with respect to the vehicle that has just crosses the obstruction, and the vehicle was traveling from the inner lane. All right, so this is the point that need to be considered in this scenario, otherwise everything is more or less similar to what we studied in the previous case. So this is the line of sight, and this is again our sight distance. Having a the curve has a radius r from the center, and we have to calculate the setback distance. Just like before, we will bisect and we will have an angle alpha by 2 and alpha by 2. Now let us derive the expression for this situation. We have m is equals to, it will be r minus, first of all let us name them, okay? We have this, let us take this point as A, this point as B, and this point as C. So we have this R minus BO, right? So we have R minus BO. So for calculation of BO, let us take triangle ABO, and from here again cos alpha by 2 is equals to BO divided by AO. So this will become BO divided by, now keep in mind this AO is the overall radius minus this distance D, alright, minus this distance D. So this will become R minus D. Okay, so your BO is equals to R minus D cos alpha by 2. So your setback distance becomes R minus D cos alpha by 2. Alright, this is the expression for the setback distance when length is greater than the sight distance for the double lane road. All right, just like previous case, here again we have L equals to R into theta, this is side distance. Your R in this case will be this one because we are taking with reference to the inner lane of the two lane road, right? We are considering the inner lane, so this distance is R minus D. We are considering this arc, so please keep this in mind. There are two things, is that first thing that we are taking inner lane as our reference, so that is why the second thing is this obstruction is with respect to the inner lane, because many a times this is what the mistake happens. And if instead of center line the question says, sometime question may come that instead of center line you have to find out the setback distance with respect to the inner lane of the horizontal curve, then the derivation has to be done with that respect. So your S is equals to R minus D and theta is alpha. So again, as it this will become r minus d divided by 2 into, sorry, into alpha by 2. So your alpha by 2 becomes s divided by 2 r minus d multiplying by 180 divided by pi. This becomes degree. Okay, so this is the expression for the when the length of the curve is greater than the side distance and we have double lane rule. Alright, let's take up the second case. Second case is when length of the curve is less than the side distance. And first of all, let us take up for the single lane road. Now here we have the horizontal curve of length LC, and at both edge we have road that is extending from the both side of the horizontal curve. So this is the length of the curve LC. And now the location of obstruction is such that at this point, from this point the line of sight is visible as it enters from this side of the curve. And so the side distance in this scenario becomes this much and the curve is this one, right? So this is the line of sight, so this is our side distance S. And this is our setback distance along the center line of the curve. So what we will do is that we will divide it into two sections. So first of all, we have curved part, right? And then we have the straight part. So this is basically the transition phase that we have, like it's almost straight now. So this is what that part is, and this is your curved part. And then again, we have the straight part. Right, so we'll divide it into two sections. The first is when there is curve and when the curve ends to the point of line of sight, that becomes our side distance. So in this case we can see that the side distance is greater than the length of the curve. This is our side distance and this is our length of the curve. Now length of the curve along the center is the radius of the curve along the center is r. And like in the previous case, we will bisect it to form angle alpha by 2 and alpha by 2. For the calculation purposes, let us name these points as A, B, C, D, E, F and G. Okay. And your setback distance M will be equal to CG plus GF. Alright, your setback distance will be CG plus GF, that is the whole length. So now let us derive the expression for this situation. So you see, here we have angle alpha by 2. So this angle will also be alpha by 2. And this is the length of the curve. This is the side distance. So if we subtract side distance from the length of the curve, we will have S minus LC. So your S minus LC is the this much distance. This is the distance AB plus DE will be equal to S minus LC, right? So for the sake of simplicity, we will consider that the AB and DE are equal. So this becomes your S minus LC by 2. Here we have S minus LC by 2, right? So if we consider, if we draw perpendicular here and name this point as H, right? So we can say that BH is equal to GF. All right, your BH will be equal to GF. All right, let's draw it clearly. So we have this angle as alpha by 2. This is your BH. This is your S minus LC by 2. S minus LC by 2. And we can say that BH is equal to GF. Now your M is equal to CG plus GF. Now CG, if we talk about CG, you will see this is the radius. So this CO is the radius of the curve, right? So from the radius of the curve, if we consider triangle BGO, if we consider triangle BGO, we can say, If you take triangle BGO and we say cos alpha by 2 is equal to GO divided by BO, GO divided by BO. So your GO is equals to BO cos alpha by 2 and your BO is R, that is R cos alpha by 2. This becomes your GO, this GO. And we know that we have seen that this is your radius, right? This is your radius. So subtracting that from this, from the radius, if you subtract this GO, we will get CG, right? So this becomes CG equals to R minus R cos alpha by 2, just like the previous case. Now for the GF, what we'll do is, for GF, taking triangle ABH, we'll take triangle ABH. So from there, sine alpha by 2 is equals to BH by S minus LC by 2, right? S minus LC by 2. So your BH is equals to S minus LC by 2 sine alpha by 2. And your BH is equal to GF. So this expression becomes R minus R cos alpha by 2 plus L minus LC by S minus LC by 2 into sine alpha by 2, right? This is the expression when length of the curve, when length of the curve is less than the side distance for single lane road, that is case 1, right? Similarly for alpha by 2, following the same procedure, we have alpha by 2 equals to 180 length of the curve divided by 2 pi r in degrees. Okay, I hope this is pretty much clear to you. If you have any doubt, you can ask me in the comment section. Now let's move on to the second case. And following the same procedure, that is, we have a center line of the road of second lane, that is at the inner side of the curve, right? We have the lane that is at inner side of the curve. This is the center line of that. And by considering the same scenarios, the formula becomes M equals to R minus D. So considering the same procedure, the formula becomes M equal to R minus D cos alpha by 2 plus S minus LC by 2 sine alpha by 2, where alpha by 2 is 180 LC divided by 2 pi R minus D degree. Try and derive this by your own. If you have any doubt, you can ask me in the comment section. Alright, so this is the formula for, so this is the formula for the situation when length of the curve is less than the, when length of the curve is less than the side distance and the, we have double lane road. Okay. Now let us do a question on this for better understanding. Now the question is that there is a horizontal highway curve of radius 400 meter and the length is 200 meters on this highway. We have to compute the setback distance required from the center line of inner side of the curve so as to provide for case 1 stopping side distance of 90 meter for a single lane road, and the second part is the overtaking side distance of 300 meters when the distance between the center line of the road and the inner lane is 1.9 meter. So first of all, we will be doing part 1. Okay, so in the part 1 it says that the side distance is 90 meter and the length of the curve is 200 meter. So we can say that the length of the curve is greater than the side distance, and it is for the single lane road. So this is for the single lane road. Okay, so now let us proceed. So first of all, we will draw the diagram. So let us draw the diagram. We have a curve, right? We have a curve, and the side distance in that curve is 90 meters. All right. So this means that this is the line of sight. Right, this is the obstruction. This is the setback distance that we have to find. The radius of this curve is, let me draw it again. The radius of this curve is 400 meters. So by bisecting, we will have this angle as alpha by 2, this angle as alpha by 2, right? So here in the question, the angle is not given. So first of all, we have to find out the angle. So let us find out the angle. And we know L is equals to R into theta. Since here length of the curve is greater than the side distance, so we will take the side distance as our length, that is 90 meters is equals to radius of the curve is 400, and here theta will take alpha by 2, so it will be alpha by 2 and it will be alpha by 2, right? So your alpha by 2 is equals to 90 divided by 800 into 180 by pi. So this is 6.445. Let's take it 6.44 degree. All right. So this is the value of alpha by 2, and we have seen that your M is equals to R minus R cos alpha by 2. So this becomes 400 minus 400 cos 6.44 degree. So this becomes 400 minus 397.47. So this value comes out to be 2.53 meters. Okay, so this is your answer for the part 1. Okay, so this is the answer for the part 1. Now let us move on to the next part, that is overtaking side distance of 300 meters when the distance between center line of the road and the inner lane is 1.9 meter. So in this case, the side distance is 300 meters. So it will be next case, plus we have double lane scenario. We have this curve, and the length of the curve is, as given in the question, 200 meters. The side distance is 300 meter, and we have this obstruction. The center line distance is 1.9 meter, So what we'll do is we will divide it into two part. We have center, the radius is 400 meter. We have to find out the setback distance, just like what we did in the while doing the derivations. We'll divide by alpha by 2 and alpha by 2. All right. So let's do the solution for the part 2. Just following the same procedure, we have alpha by 2 is equals to 14.39. All right. And your m is equal to cg plus gf, right? And we have seen the formula r minus z cos alpha by 2 plus s, that is the side distance minus the length of the curve, divided by 2 sine alpha by 2. So keeping those values, the value comes out to be 27 meter. All right, your r is 400, the d is 1.9 as given in the question. Your side distance is 300 meters, again length of the curve is 200 meters, and from here we have got the value of sine, the value of alpha by 2, that is 4.39, and by putting this value we will get the answer as 27 meter. Okay, so this is how the questions are done in this topic. So here is a question for you to attempt. The question is that while allowing a highway in a built up area, it was necessary to provide a horizontal curve of radius 325 meter. You have to design the following geometric features. The first is superelevation, second is extra widening of the pavement, third is length of the transition curve, and the available data are design speed is equals to 65 km per hour, length of the wheelbase of largest truck is equal to 6 meters, and the pavement width is equal to 10.5 meters. So this is a question that you have to do and submit to me. If you have any doubt, you can ask in the comment section. Okay, so this was all about the setback distance of the horizontal curve. I hope the topic was clear to you. If you have any doubt, just ask in the comment section and try and do more numericals on this. And again, if you encounter some doubt, ask me. I will try and resolve it. Right, because more the numericals you will do, the better the concept will be cleared. All right, thank you.